Welcome to Dunkirk Spoiler Loaded Review! If you haven't seen the spoiler-free section, you should, so click on the card here and then come back here. There's something wrong with the concept of quantity in this film. Spoiler alert! Hi, I am Javier and this is The Geek Filter. Watch until the end for my extra thought on the film. So quantity. Why am I talking about quantity? We often see epic movies of great deeds that involves large quantities. Or do you think that the final showdown between Aragorn's and Sauron's army could have been done with only two people on each side? It definitely doesn't have the same effect on people, right? So Dunkirk started off saying that there were 400,000 soldiers stranded on the beach. That's a large number. I couldn't count how many there were on screen, but I'm sure there weren't more than 1,000. And then when we learn that the solution for them to go home is for civilian boats to come pick them up, you'd expect to see a large fleet of them approaching the shore on the climactic scene, right? Wrong. I think there were about 10 or 15 ships on screen. Unnervingly disappointing. So Nolan doesn't give us a relatable character or story whatsoever. Okay, he takes away the blood and guns. Okay, it's not that kind of movie. But if your film is relying on the fact that a lot, and I mean a lot, of British civilian ships come to rescue their boys, you'd expect to see them. But you don't! You don't! I'm sorry I get a bit upset, but it's because the solution to this is so simple. Just CGI your way to achieving that and it's done. I get so mad because it feels like they just didn't want to do it.
Hey Christopher, you think we should get more boats here or what?
Whatever, I'm still gonna win Best of Actor.
I mean, you've deliberately built your movie up to this moment and you failed to deliver. Come on! I think this moment takes even more significance when at the end of the film, we'll learn they finally got almost 300,000 soldiers back home instead of the 30,000 that the British government, represented by Kenneth Branagh's character, expected to rescue. Don't get me wrong, I'm not a war movie buff. I'm not one of those that don't like a movie if it doesn't have blood or guns or death in it. No offense. But I'm not complaining about a big fleet just for the sake of it, just for the visual impact. I think it's a dramatic necessity. I mean, the story needs it. It is built around that moment, about how the soldiers get rescued. And the film has shown us the relatable story of Mark Rylance's character, Mr. Dawson, and his son and his helper, and you unconsciously assume that the other men on board the other small vessels have had a similar rough time getting there. So that part was also to build you up for this crucial moment. I think Nolan was aiming to get a deep emotional response from us when we see this particular private boat, along with some others, coming to the beach to rescue everyone. But I think it should have been accompanied by so many more vessels. This way the impact would have been stronger. Or in my case, it would have at least appeared. Because I was nothing but pissed off during this scene. Since we're talking about some facts that relate to the real life stories, let me break down the synopsis included in the previous video. The movie never states that in the evacuation, they rescued soldiers that weren't British. It actually says the opposite. When Tommy, Fionn Whitehead, and another soldier are carrying a wounded man on a gurney, they go through some kind of checkpoint. And you see one British soldier preventing some French-speaking soldiers to enter the dock. And also on the whole ship scene, the rioting British soldiers vote to throw the French one out. In real life, all stranded Allied forces were to be evacuated. That may be just right. We do see the soldiers and Navy officers at the beach and dock trying to get the forces back home. We do see the small vessels come and the destroyers get sunk. And we do see the Air Force pilots trying to defend the infantry from German planes' attacks. But I'm not sure it's the right summary for the film's synopsis. Acclaimed auteur means that Christopher Nolan is a filmmaker that likes to control every aspect of the movie, and that he is acclaimed by the critics. But yet again, they mention Allied troops, whereas in the film, only British soldiers are rescued. One last thing I wanted to address is that we don't get to see the enemy. Although it might seem kind of disappointing, I think it's a good call, because the writer, also Nolan, wanted to concentrate the film in the story of the evacuation, not the battle. And I think that hiding the enemies from plain sight and not even mentioning the word German throughout the whole movie, I think they don't, actually achieves this. Extra thought! Nolan said that the story of Dunkirk hasn't been addressed in modern cinema. Funny enough, that same year, 2017, the movie Darkest Hour came out, depicting the same story but from Churchill's perspective. I think it's an incredible coincidence. And I say coincidence because we will never know if Warner Brothers was somehow in sync with Darkest Hour producers. I think they weren't, but you never know. Also, I just discovered there's a 1958 film called Dunkirk. I'm gonna find it and then watch it. I'll tell you when I do. So what do you think? Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more film reviews on The Geek Filter. And be sure to check out my Patreon page, where there's exclusive spoiler-loaded content with even more comments about each film. Thanks for watching. Bye!